Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 742, and today's topic is the medicinal importance and uses of nicotine. And if I say nicotine, means it is globally known as tobacco alkaloid. And I have already given you the briefing or some introduction about the tobacco alkaloid, and today I am going to discuss more specifically nicotine, because once we are talking of tobacco, nicotine is one of the most important alkaloid in tobacco. The reason is that it is physiologically, pharmacologically very active. It is a very good stimulant, and also it has lot of physiological impact, means you can be addicted and your lot of health problems are associated with this. And this nicotine, if I am saying that is tobacco alkaloid, people globally today more than 1 billion people are addicted to tobacco. So that tobacco use is in two ways. One, by chewing. And this chewing of tobacco is very common in Indian subcontinent, especially in India and Bangladesh. And chewing of tobacco is very, very harmful as compared to smoking of tobacco. So two conditions of using tobacco are there. One, either you are chewing it or you are smoking it. Once you are chewing the tobacco, it means that you are taking nicotine in concentrated form. And if you are smoking the cigarette, and cigarette means one cigarette may contain up to 15 gram of tobacco, and that tobacco contains 4% nicotine. So one cigarette will contain 1.5 gram of nicotine, and in smoke form it will combine with oxygen, and with that combination you are inhaling it, and that one will contain only with 1.4 milligram, or up to we can say 20 to 30 milligram you are receiving. But 40 milligram of nicotine is fatal. It can cause lot of health problem, means immediately you will be nervous and your concentration will be drastically reduced, and heart palpitation, lot of changes will come. But the reason is that why we are not feeling after smoking, that once 20, 30, 40 milligram is reaching to your body through your lung, because immediately your body will clear them. It is all immediately cleared and disintegrated by your body. That's why that smoking is not causing immediate harm. Rather than it is cumulative. If you are smoking for many years, then there will be cumulative health harm. And the history of tobacco goes, it has long history of 2000 years. And Americanas, they were using it as a medicine as well as stimulant. Then at that time, people were very much aware of its toxicity. Then it came to Europe, and I have already told you that in Europe, this tobacco or nicotine, they were using as a punishment. By that time, that was in 1600, cigarette smoking came. And people started rolling the cigarette, either in the form of pipe or in the form of cigar. And by 1800, lot of factories and mechanical production started. So it was a big business in 1900. Tobacco business, cigarette business, and many were addicted. But thank God that in the year 2009, globally, people realized that no, we must stop smoking because it is having a lot of health hazard. Lot of people are addicted. And if anybody who is addicted to smoking or tobacco, chewing, sometimes you can be recovered from that addiction, or you can quit the addiction of heroin and cocaine. But it is very difficult to quit the addiction of smoking and chewing the tobaccos. So globally the step was taken that publicly by under the WHO, World Health Organization, that we should stop smoking publicly at public place, at airport, in aeroplane, and they separated the cabin, the smokers' cabin, everywhere. So with that, there is a drastic reduction in use of smoked tobacco, smoked nicotine and tobacco nicotine in the form of chewing. So today I will be discussing the nicotine. The formula of nicotine is C10H14N2, means it contains 10 carbon, 14 nitrogen, I mean 14 hydrogen and 2 nitrogen. It is having two rings. One is where nitrogen is the part of aromatic ring, that is called pyridine nucleus, and the other nucleus is 5 member ring, that is pyridine. So it is made up of 6 member pyridine nucleus and 5 member pyrrole nucleus. And this nicotine is having boiling point 264, and it is oily, it is less soluble in water, but it is highly soluble in in organic solvents like alcohol, chloroform, benzene and ether. So I will be discussing its structure and its medicinal properties. So here I have given all the details what I have already told you about the tobacco alkaloid, which is commonly known as nicotine. And I have already told you once, I said tobacco. Tobacco is used globally. Either they are chewing it or they are smoking it. So here, the medicinal properties and uses of nicotine. The botanical name is Nicotiana tabacum, and it belongs to family Solanaceae. Number one, nicotine is tobacco alkaloid, and it is also known as tobacco smoke alkaloid. So either you call it tobacco, if we are calling it tobacco alkaloid, means we are limited to leaf, chewing of the leaf, how they are using, is very common in Indian subcontinent. And once we are talking of smoke, means it is cigarette, cigar or pipe. Nowadays the cigar and pipe is not very common, but I have already told you that in 1700, it was the sign of prosperity or luxury to have pipe like Churchill and all others. You can see them chewing the cigar. And in cigar, actually two things they were doing. They were chewing it at one end, and other end it was smoking. So all these were there in Europe. But nowadays it is drastically reduced. So that is called smoke alkaloid. Because tobacco smoke mainly contain nicotine, and the average nicotine content of tobacco leaf is approximately 4%. So all these tobacco leaves, they contain 4% alkaloidal tobacco leaf alkaloids, and that is mainly nicotine. On being smoked, part of nicotine is burned, and some part is inhaled by human body. So once we are smoking, the one part of the nicotine is burned with that cigarette fire, and the one which we are inhaling in the form of smoke, that is going to our lung, and through lung it goes to our blood and body tissues. Human body, therefore, a single cigarette with a nicotine content of 1.4%, so your single cigarette which contains 1.4% might possess 14 milligram of nicotine. So in one cigarette which is having 1.4% nicotine, if we are smoking, we can get up to 14 milligram nicotine, and 5 gram cigarette approximately contains 70 milligram of nicotine. So that 70 milligram of nicotine, once it is burned, so of course drastically some nicotine is burned, but up to it goes up to 20 to 30 milligram to our lung. But the fatal dose of nicotine for human being, as I have already told you, is 40 to 50 milligram. But the beauty of our body is that once we are smoking, immediately whatever nicotine we are receiving, our body system will immediately, it will be disintegrated or it will be eliminated, so that we will not be having that chronic effect of poisonous, toxic effect of nicotine immediately, but there will be cumulative effect. The fact is that smoking is practiced without causing immediate death is explained by the ability of the human body to degrade and eliminate nicotine rapidly. This is actually, that's why our body itself is a hospital. Lot of chemical reactions are going on, and because of those reactions, we are well protected. So the residual nicotine may exhibit symptoms like, now whatever residual is remaining after all disintegration and elimination, some little amount will be remaining, and that will go on accumulating in years, because people are having the habit formation of smoking for 20 years, 30 years, 40 years. So within that period, residual accumulation of nicotine will be there in body, and it will cause the physiological, biological impact, your health impact. And what are those health impact? The residual nicotine may exhibit symptoms like nervousness. So those heavy smokers, Chinese smokers I call them, those who are using 30, 40 cigarettes every day, 2-3 packets every day, they are known as heavy smokers, Chinese smokers. They will be always nervous. I mean, they will not be very strong and stable in terms of mental health. Also, chronic bronchitis, sometimes there will be tendency of sneezing and then coughing, cough-oofing, all these things. Then, stomatitis means stomach disorder, and it has very strong link of cardiovascular disease that they are linking that tobacco smokers, they get lung cancer also. And smoking this nicotine can cause the blood clotting. So it has lot of health problem. And that's why in 2009, WHO came in action, World Health Organization, and globally people they agreed that we will stop smoking drastically at public places. So with that, I mean, there is a reduction in smoking, but still chewing of the tobacco, which is more dangerous. Most of the oral cancer and lung problem and your respiratory problem is associated with chewing of the tobaccos, which is very, very common in Indian subcontinent as well as in Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and India. In Nigeria, there is habit of chewing of the alkaloid, but that is not tobacco, that is called cola nut. Cola nut, what stimulation they are getting is because of the presence of alkaloid in there, cola alkaloid. And they are habitual, they have the habit formation of chewing the cola nut. This habit is also harmful to our health, but it is the part of their, I mean, in Nigeria, I have noticed this thing that if there is any marriage ceremony, they will bring at least 4 or 5 packets, maybe 40-50 kg of kola nut as a gift. So it is a part of their traditional or cultural values. So today I will stop here, and tomorrow I am going to discuss more, that is part 2 of nicotine, because nicotine, this tobacco alkaloid, it has long history of killing many people. And if you remember, I mentioned that British government, they were using cigarette to punish the criminals. Once they are put behind the jail, they were given to smoke 20-30 cigarette, so that they are very much we can say exhausted, and nervousness, and is a type of fatigue. It was physical fatigue, and because of that reason, the British, they developed the smoking of cigarette. Smoking started with pipe and cigar. And today, of course, I mean, nicotine is one of the alkaloid. It has some positive effect also once it is converted in the form of nicotinic acid. So all these things I am going to discuss in second part. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.